Oh, hi there. I'm the great Orbax. We're here today with Dr. Mike Massa to discuss the concept of elasticity. Prior to this point in your academic career, you may only know of elasticity via the law of rubber and glue, i.e., I'm rubber, you're glue, what I say bounces off me and sticks to you. Now, as much as you've lived your life by this principle, it turns out that that's only a first approximation to a much deeper rule about elastic materials. Okay. Dr. Massa?
Okay. All right. Here's the deeper rule that we've been talking about. When you stretch or compress something, you can deform it by applying a force. Now, we call this compression or tension. Now, the amount of force that you apply influences how much deformation you're going to get. And we would start with some original length and have its length change, increase, or decrease by an amount called delta L.
So to go through all these, this is the change in length
compared
to what the initial length actually is.
Right.
This is the force that's applied, whether it's being stretched or whether it's being pushed against. This is that external force. And then this A value is area.
Yeah, the cross-sectional area is really important in how it responds.
So something like pushing on two sides of a brick versus pushing on a tube of the same material would give us a different value.
Absolutely, yeah. And then this last bit is called the Young's modulus.
Why?
Yeah, I get you. That's the material property. That's just how stiff a material is, whether it's rubbery, like rubber, and has a low Young's modulus or something that's stiffer.
Why?
It'll have a higher Young's modulus.
So it's literally a numerical index. The bigger that value, the harder it is to change this initial length.
Exactly. So let's do a typical example problem here. Let's suppose you jump off of a 10-foot tall wall. Mm-hmm. When you land, your legs are going to compress while that force of deceleration is applied. So let's say that you experience a force of 1,500 newtons as you brace yourself.
So I hit the ground, 1,500 newtons is applied to my legs.
Yeah. Now, your femur is typically about a foot long, say 30 centimeters in length. And we'd like to know how much that's actually going to compress while that 1,500 newton force is applied. Bone is elastic, like many other materials, and the Young's modulus for that is 9 times 10 to the 9 newtons per meter squared. So it's a force per unit area. And then finally, the cross-sectional area of your femur is typically about 4 square centimeters. So we have all the numbers we need to calculate this one unknown. And what I've done is I've given it to you in a variety of units, because I think that's one thing where possibly the most challenging part of this problem is making sure that you do your unit conversion.
Right. So the first thing we should do is convert these into SI units. Force is already in newtons, so that's fine. Our modulus is in newtons per meter squared, both SI units. L naught is easy to convert from 30 centimeters. It's just a value of 0.30 meters. And that leaves us with the area. In terms of the actual area, we've got 4 centimeters squared. One of the most common problems that people have with this is improper unit conversions. 4 centimeters squared is not the same thing as 0.04 meters squared.
Right.
To convert from centimeters squared to meters squared, you have to realize that there is 1 meter per 100 centimeters. But we square that entire amount. So what that means is it's actually 4 divided by 100 divided by 100. So 4 times 10 to the negative 4 meters squared.
Okay. Everything's in SI units. And so at this point, it's calculator work. Let's not bother going and rearranging the expression. But the final answer that you're going to get is 1.3 times 10 to the minus 4. Everything is in SI units, so this change in length comes out in meters.
And if you're looking at that in terms of millimeters, that'd be 0.13 millimeters.
Yeah, so it's a very tiny amount of deformation. And again, it's elasticity, right? So this compression happens while that force is applied, but as soon as you land and you walk away, you're back to the usual just force of gravity of your body, and your leg returns to its original length.
I know you are, but what am I? I think that rubber glue thing from